Okay, so I had to escape the house a bit today, and I'm gonna try ice fishing. The ice isn't very thick, so I don't trust it to walk on it, but here you got a little bit of a dock that goes out. So right off the dock, I'm going to drill some holes, and this is a trout pond, but there's also pike. So I'm gonna put down a tip up for pike, but I'm gonna be jigging by hand for trout. Right here next to the camera. Okay, so I put three holes down. Now I'll just scoop them out and I'll get my stuff going for fishing. Okay, so I'm fishing now. I have a hook down one hole that has a nice smelt on it for the pike, and I have a little shrimp imitation here that I'll put down for trout. Let's get it untangled and get fishing. We'll see what happens. I have it so that I'll just barely see the flag of my tip up and a fish bite. And always be safe with the amount of ice that there is, because nobody likes falling through the ice. Ah, got a nice one. Or feels like a nice one at least. Not too bad. Not great, but not bad. Come up for a photo once you get the hook out. Nice little trout. I'll actually keep that guy for breakfast when I go home. So that's about regular size here for decent ones. That's good. Got one already. I have to go get a stringer. Okay, I got that guy on the stringer. And here's a trick. I don't know if you can see, but my hook is kind of hanging. It's hanging vertically. If you want to have a better chance of catching fish, you have to hang it. Sorry, when your gloves stick to it. You have to hang it kind of horizontally. That allows them to get hooked better on the hook. Anyways, I'll get this down. Hopefully, catch another one quick. That's pretty quick. I haven't seen anything happen on my pike rig yet, but there aren't a ton of pike in here. I've seen decent ones, so should be able to catch something. But most of the pike I see in here are really small, like under a foot. It's little babies, but I've seen some in the 4 pound range. So we'll see if I cannot get a bite on the pike rig too. I'm sure I can keep busy with the trout rig. I was here the other day and caught over 20 trout, mind you. Most of them were just the small, freshly released from the hatchery trout, so they were like around 10 inches each. Oh, there's a bite. And now I'm gonna reel it up because the bite has put my hook vertically again. That did not work. There's also trout here. I mean, there's also perch here. See if I can learn how to speak English properly. But there's also perch here, so some of these little bites that don't stick could easily be perch. Because perch are horrible at doing that. I've caught a few perch here, but not many. I've seen a ton. I've seen a ton of perch here. But they're all so small that they're too small to really bite a hook yet. Oh, there is a bite again, jeez. I just sit here jigging it a little bit before I put it back to being horizontal. I'm sure it's back to being vertical. Nothing on the pike rig. Maybe they clean the place out for pike. Doubt it. And it's back to being vertical. Gotta be horizontal. Yeah, this red shrimp imitation that I'm using, I'm not talking the shrimp that most guys use, well, lots of guys use for trout, like the ones that you buy for Christmas to eat with your cocktail sauce. This looks like freshwater shrimp from around here. And the trout in this pond love it. It's very effective here. And I make all my own flies, so that's really good because I know how to change up the hooks just a little bit and I don't have to go to the store and get ripped off for a hook or a fly. And if there's enough interest, if enough of you guys, oh, there's a small dinky guy. Look at that little dinky guy. That's like fresh from the hatchery right there. Put that guy back down the hole. It makes me sick when I see idiots coming to these ponds and keeping the little tiny guys. It's like, why are you keeping them? There's no meat on them. There he goes. Now he'll be here for one of those idiots to keep one that's tiny. But don't keep the small guys. They're not worth it. Just put them back in the pond. Let them grow. Come back. Catch it when it's bigger. It's better that way. So I was fishing here the other day doing this exact same thing. Sorry, I didn't film. But there were two guys fishing here. And they said that they had been ice fishing. They had the fire department called on them. Someone that lives nearby called the fire department on them saying that they're fishing on unsafe ice. There's a sign here that says unsafe ice, but honestly, if you want to go walk out on ice, it's your own problem. And I could probably walk safely on this ice. It's about 2 inches thick, and it's decently clear, which means that it's pretty strong. But I like my ice thicker still. So I'm just going to be sitting here on the dock. It's working so far. Still nothing on the pike rig. Kind of surprised I'm not getting more bites for trout. The other day it was insane how many bites I was getting. I was missing like half of them though. So that shows you how it was. It's a perfectly calm day out here. Woke up at 6:30 to get out here. My wife has to work today, so she'll be gone when I get home. But got for movie and food after. So she's done work today. So that'll be fun. I was actually hunting the other day, and I shot a really big 3x3 buck. It probably wouldn't get more. It would. Yeah, English. English is important. Why can't I just speak in Spanish to you guys? But I shot a 3x3 buck, and it probably wouldn't have gotten bigger than 3x3. It was massive, and the nose on the buck was super wide, showing that it was pretty darn old. But it's a nice buck. My dad and I both I always say guesstimate, so guess slash estimate. That was probably around like the 300-pound mark. It's just a huge deer. It's still just a 3x3. Super, super wide 3x3, really high. So that's why we're pretty sure he never would have gotten any bigger. And then we went out after that, about like 2-3 hours after I got the buck, because we took it home and skinned it and got it ready. Hung it up in the garage, and we went out and we got myself a white-tailed doe. And it's amazing with white-tailed does because they'll sit in the tiniest little patch of stuff. We're just walking along and we see this patch of stuff. And it might be up to like, not even up to my waist. It's probably between my knees and my waist, and I'm 6 foot. And we're walking up and both of us are like, okay, there's gotta be white-tailed in there because they hide in the tiniest little bit of stuff. Sure enough, when we get up close, 3 white-tailed does all pop out of there. So I quickly just shot one. And then we had a long retrieve for that one because we had to hike well for that. But we have a sled, so we just carry it. We tow it behind us. That's good. Hard to film when you're hunting though, unless you have a GoPro. I don't have a GoPro though, so hard to hunt. I'll film while hunting. So if anybody if you want to sponsor me and get me a GoPro, that'd be a good gift. Christmas gifts. Can't believe I haven't had another bite. I'm gonna check my hook and see what's up. Looks good. Weird. Put it back down. Yeah, I have to take my trout out the other hole. What I always do is, I know a lot of fools that just leave the fish on the ice to freeze solid. And when they get home, they have to thaw it to clean it. I think that's just stupid. Because it like lowers the quality of the meat too. So what I do is I put it on a stringer and I get my auger, a little pathetic hand auger, and I connect the stringer to that and put it down a hole. And that way, they don't freeze solid, nice and fresh. And I can go home. They'll be nice and fresh, and I can cut the meat off. And be ready to eat. You don't have to wait for it to thaw. It's higher quality. You don't want your meat to freeze twice. You can let it freeze on the ice if you're gonna eat it right away. Oh, there's a bite. Missed it. If you're gonna eat it right away, sure, okay. Let it freeze on the ice, thaw it out, eat it. But if you're wanting to refreeze it, you should try to keep it fresh. Oh, there's one. Oh, this guy feels like a good one. Oh yeah, nice guy. Nice. And then, yeah, keep it fresh. This guy's bigger than the last guy. Just had him barely hooked by the lip. Nice trout. Now you'll see something interesting. Stockery trout, they don't typically have that fin. See that? It's totally missing on this guy. That's very common. That's a nice hatchery. Put that one on a stringer for the wife. She'll be happy. She likes trout. I put a honey dill sauce on my trout and salmon. I actually got lots of salmon in the freezer. But see? Nice trout. I have to get my butt up and put it on the stringer. Oh, there, I got that guy on the stringer. And hook down again. See what doesn't want to bite. One thing I wish with these ponds in the cities that I fish in, I wish that the trout got bigger. But honestly, the size that I've kept so far, like, as big as I've ever seen in like ponds in cities. So that's all I'm gonna keep. So hopefully some get bigger, but I doubt it. Yeah, Oh, there's a bite already, jeez. I can tell that one will put, my hook. Vertical. I don't want it to be vertical. I need to like make a hook that somehow can't go vertical. That'd be smart. It's probably invented though, so I guess not. I guess it won't invent it because it's probably already invented. Just have to go onto Amazon, try to find it. And part of the problem is that I need to put a heavier weight on here because the line is not very tight. It's a very light hook. It does have a little bit of wire wrapping around it, but I should put lead wire inside of it to make it even heavier. I'll do that next time. I'd like to see that fillet go up on the tip up. Oh, there's a nibble. I think that was perch. That's pathetically small. If I had like bait on, I'd be catching tons and tons and tons of perch, I bet. Perch don't really like the plain hooks so much. They'll bite. But they don't like them so much. I'm guessing that my hook's vertical again. I need to put it horizontal. Lame. This is really funny. The two guys that were fishing here the other day. The one guy I was catching probably about as much as me. He's doing pretty good. But the other guy, he didn't catch one fish while I was here. And the funny thing is that they're friends, so they're fishing together. And the guy that's catching quite a few, he's like, oh, you need to switch your hook, man. The other guy's like, no, I'm going to keep using this. And never caught anything. The whole time I was here, I didn't seem to catch one fish. I feel like I need to try something else, but we'll see. It's just, if you got something that works, why would you switch, right? There's a little dinky guy. Yeah, see? A little dinky. Pathetic. That's hardly a fish. Put that one back down the hole. It's actually pretty good. All its fins are in place. It's not common for hatchery fish. Most of the time they're missing a few. Fins are such... Still nothing on the pike. Rig. There aren't many pike here, but it'll still be fun to catch one or two or three or four when you're in here. So here's something. So if you know the province I'm fishing in, if you're fishing and catch anything but trout in a trout pond, and it's not listed in the regulations, can't legally keep it anymore. It's retarded. I think the idea behind it is so that people don't start like stocking perch, pike, or walleye into trout ponds trying to create it, like get those fish in there. I think it's retarded is because now you got like a pond like this with pike in it, and legally you can't keep the pike. So the pike get big, and the pike eat the trout. And the pike eat the trout, there's no trout to catch. So, your stupid law making stuff right there. It's like figure out where the ponds are that already have stuff in it and do something about the pike. Like come in here with a huge net, catch all the pike. I don't know, put up a sign here that says that you have to kill every pike that you catch. That would be good. You know how lawmakers are. Most of the laws are good, but there's a few that are really stupid. I'm not going into politics, though. Come on, pike. Go for that rig. So with my pike rigs, what I do is, since you're allowed three hooks on a online when you're ice fishing. Well, actually when you're fishing anytime. What I do is I learned this from my dad. I got a jig head in the middle, and then I got two small trebles on the sides. So what I do is I put the jig head through the middle of the bait. Right now I got smelts. I don't like using smelts most of the time. I normally use spot tail shiners. I catch myself. And then I put the trebles, one treble on the head, one treble on the tail. So basically, fish comes to bite, you're gonna hook it. It's really effective. I'm really starting to wonder though if my stringer down there is like scaring all the other fish away. I'm not getting bites. Last winter I took some people ice fishing from Britain. They had never ice fished before. Oh, there's a bite, jeez. Should stop talking and start fishing. But caught a ton of trout for them. They were so happy, so happy. And that's why I fish guide. Mind you, this winter I don't have any yet lined up. So if you want to go fishing, look at my Facebook page, contact me, and I'll take you fishing. Got pretty good rates compared to most of the guys that do it around here. Oh, look at that, it's vertical again. But I'd say I almost guarantee fish. Anybody that guarantees fish is a liar. Can't guarantee fish. Never can. I've been out in the ocean in some of the best waters for fishing. And the weather just doesn't work. The tides are wrong. And the fish just didn't bite. Or the guy that's been fishing there his whole life. And it's like, well, sorry guys. But when the weather and the tides do this, I can't do anything. So I was like, yeah, I understand. You can't control fish. So there you go. If a guy guarantees you fish, telling them that they're full of it, get a fishing guide that's truthful. So lately I've been noticing that a lot of guys have been starting to make some of their own lures and trying to sell them. Some of them actually look really good. So, if you're one of those guys making your own lures and you want me to advertise for you, send me a couple. I'll use them. I catch fish. They look good. People will buy them from you. Just a thought. Got another nice guy, but since I already got two, I'm gonna be putting this one back. See? It's another nice trout from here. Not huge for sure, but still nice for a little city pond. I'll be putting that one back. And oh, my battery says it's even fuller than it was before. That's good. Maybe I'll start talking more. You know, you're probably bored of me. Back she goes. I just got another decent one, not as good as some of the other ones I caught, but still decent. Gotta get it off the hook and I'll show ya. Okay. So, just like that. Not very nice, but still fish. Still fun. Back down the hole he goes. The fish and I go. If you haven't been able to see me due to the sun, but just got another little tiny guy. No matter what the size, it's still going to be releasing them now. Gotta make sure they don't stand out my tripod, leg down the hole. Starting to warm up a little bit. don't even know how many fish I've caught now. Probably like, I have to look over the footage again, but I think 7 or 8, maybe. I'm not sure. Probably 7 or 8. Interesting to know how many. I suck at paying attention to how many I got. I really need to start bringing a piece of paper with me and keeping a tally. That's the only way I'd ever be able to tell you how many fish I've caught in total. I try not to be one of those fools that like catches 2 fish and says he caught 20. I'm not a zero adder. Oh, he just got off, but he'll definitely have been big enough to do that to my hook, put it vertically. Hate that. It's got to be horizontal. If it ain't horizontal, I ain't fishing. One problem with ice fishing, you don't get with regular fishing, is that the eyes or loops on your rod freeze full of water. Sometimes you gotta take your gloves off and you gotta melt those chunks of ice just so you can get your line down. Well, I just got one that takes the prize for the smallest fish of the day. Can't believe how small that is. Wow, that's not so bad to me, is it? Yeah, it's a tiny, tiny little trout. I'll be putting that back down full happily. He's got a while to go before he'll be big. Maybe medium. It slowed down a lot. Like, I think it's been about probably 10 minutes since I last turned on my camera. That's quite a while without a bite. Thinking soon I might put on something for pike, just to see if I can't catch some pike, because that could be fun. So, looks like it's the hour of the dinkies. Another little tiny trout. Someone put some food in this lake, get these fish fattened up, come on. I think it's one more nice one just to say that I would have caught on the limit of keepers. Well, let's see. Nope, that's just another little guy. Not as little as last guy. Wait, come on, you're acting like a tuna right now. Or mackerel. Well, mackerel is a tuna. Just not holding still. Holy cow. Jeez. A lot easier if you held still, buddy. There he goes, right down the hole. Okay, caught a small guy. Not as dinky as some of those. Some of those ones today were just incredibly small. But yet again, it was like probably 7 to 10 minutes since I caught my last fish. Oh, that guy does not want to go down the hole. Come on, buddy. There he goes. One of those fish that you put down the hole and he jumps right back out. Wants to be human, I guess. Sadly, evolution doesn't work that fast. If you believe in that, if you're an evolution believer. If you're not, well, the whole comment was stupid.